Kentucky, the road to the championships become a little less crowded, but there still isn't enough room for both of these teams. Which team will become a casualty in the second round in this game between the Michigan State Spartans and the Baylor Bears?
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Bears know they're in for a fight tonight, Dick. What are their keys to succeed this evening?
Hey, if you ask me, the keys are simple, Brad. First, play it your style. Don't get roped into doing things that you normally don't do. You must be in control. Second of all, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. And lastly, don't get away from what got you here on defense. Don't try and do too much defensively.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. And up, in and out. The point guard takes the pass. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
Tries for two. Doesn't go. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. The shooting guard gets the ball. Looking for a good shot. Fed the low block. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Inside. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. High post flashes. There's the fake. The small forward gets the pass. From right of the circle. No luck finding the basket the last few trips down court, Dick.
What they need are some easy layups or a couple of nice putbacks.
With a little baby hook, they still don't score. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Turns it over. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Defense giving no room.
Step out on that screener.
Perfectly executed.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
Down in the low post, defensively, great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
High post flashes for the ball handler.
Up and inside.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. He'll regroup the offense. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The Bears have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Inside, on the inside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Tinsley is emotionally.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
He shoots from the top of the circle. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Count that as a personal foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Trying to pack it inside. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. it's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Got to eliminate those turnovers.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. He does the sweet fake shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
As the chance persists.
I love it, Brad. Only in college basketball, baby. Only in college basketball.
From way outside, he misses it. With the long bomb, it's no good. The ball goes out of play. At halftime, the Bears are ahead by 5. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. Michigan State seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. The power forward gets the ball. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
For the deuce.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Both teams looking to get things going. On the dribble, gives it up. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way?
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Stop and pop. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
In the paint. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. The shooting guard takes the feed. He shoots from downtown. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. The power forward receives the pass. Kicks it out. He throws it up from downtown. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
In the paint. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork. Keep
blocked. Nice job defensively.
Great play to take that to the basket.
When you're talking about the Big 12, people often mention Texas, Kansas, Oklahoma.
Yeah, Brad, they do. But it'll be interesting to see how or if the recent coaching changes will affect the style of play that the Big 12 is known for.
Picked out of the air. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Thanks, Aaron.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
10 seconds to get a shot off. Tinsley is emotionally pumped up.
Well, he's had some success and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
And the ball goes out of play. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
On the outside, Tinsley handles the pass.
The frustration right there. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Long pounded on his way up. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Makes his first. No finish on that one. Tinsley receives the ball. And the ball goes out of bounds. I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them gap. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Defense made him keep it too long. There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in the game at the end drops significantly.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
The clock stopped with a foul. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Foul, man. That stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped with a foul. The Bears are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. Makes it. Hits the second.
They need to score here to turn this to a one-possession game.
Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. Play about ready to resume. He shoots from the angle. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Bears graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.